Welcome along to the first ever Pub Scrawl here in Sheffield. So, what's going to happen? Well, there's 10 venues across Sheffield where, for one night only, Mr. McKee has arranged for artists to put in an installation. Might be pictures, who knows what we've got in store for you this evening. As I said, it's special in many counts because you guys are all involved. All we'd ask is that during the evening, we've got around half an hour in each of the venues, so your tour guide will let you know roughly what time we'll be leaving. So if you could be outside the venues kind of 2-3 minutes before, so no last minute pit stops there, Mr. Dean. So be outside the venues, look after each other and have a great evening this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Pete McKee!
Thank you ever so much for taking part in this year of great sports. From a little acorn of an idea of having a group exhibition in a pub, we've expanded it to a pub crawl where they've got 10 brilliant pubs, 10 fantastic artists, but some really famous ones, some on the way up, and they all need your support and help, especially the ones on the way up. They're absolute geniuses and I love them. And the fact that you've all turned up on a rainy night in Sheffield is a testimony to how fantastic Sheffield people are and how so much they're up for having a good time and getting pissed, and that's absolutely it warms my heart, I can tell you. What's on show at the moment is Ian Anderson. Now, Ian Anderson is a shining light in Sheffield art and graphic design. He was a pioneer. He was the one that said, you can stay in Sheffield and you can make it. This man, he exhibits, he earns a living in New York, Tokyo, the whole world. And he has Sheffield as his base, and the man's an absolute legend. And I'm in love with the man, he's brilliant. And he's a Sheffield Wednesday supporter. Every pub has got something unique and wonderful, and it's a real surprise, and it's a joy. And so thank you very much for taking part in the first ever pub scrawl. You'll be able to say to your grandkids, I got pissed on this song. All right, up they are.
The basic idea behind it is the kind of the space between what we say and what we mean. And I think, you know, it's especially working with clients, you know, obviously you kind of tell people what they want to hear, and in terms of the art world, the things are described in terms of almost anything other than actually kind of what you're looking at, which is that kind of the critic's vocabulary. But really, most of the work that I do is about people and how people interact, so, and really that's all this is. There's 9 screens, because as if there's 9 conversations going on at different speeds, and not everything is, it's not just a simple like dialogue between sort of 2 people of like, you know, I want, I need, I love, I hate. It's just lots of things all having a different speed, and there's no real, it's very difficult to grab hold of anything. You get a sense of what's happening, but there's nothing really sort of definite about it. So it's really just the interaction between people and the space between people and the space between what they say and what they mean. And
hello.
If anyone does want the shelter of an umbrella at some point during the tour, I have got one, but it's a Wednesday umbrella. Ladies and gentlemen of Pub Scrawl group number 3, follow me!
This way, come on.
If you find a budget and all
help
that.
Yeah. It's loosely based on kind of tattoo flash imagery. I'd been doing these kind of tattoo flash sheets with kind of odd takes on traditional tattoo, like stuff that people probably would never get tattooed. So I kind of expanded on that and used all this kind of macabre imagery, skulls with quiffs and stuff like that. This is the stuff that I really enjoy doing, so I kind of jumped at the chance to fill the pub with the stuff that I think is my best work. I was just speaking to a mate actually, and he said he's from Leeds, and he was saying he'd love to see the same thing happen in Leeds, but he thinks that Sheffield has got a much stronger scene, so it's something that Sheffield can pull off really well, I think.
It's been a good crowd. Yeah, there's been like big waves when the tours hit, so it's been good. Yeah, it's kind of hard to gauge reaction, I've been that busy. I've never actually finished setting up the show, I'm still finishing it now. I don't know if that was a wise choice or not.
It could all go horribly wrong, yeah.
And in the Harley was Tom J Newell, who's an absolute favourite artist of mine. His black line work is incredible. It's so powerful, and yet, can you say delicate in the same way? But there's a kind of an emotion behind it. So that's Brother Clive there. Thank you. The work was great, and it was really nice to see him actually working on it as well at the same time. I think that's always important for people to see artists at work, because I'm not saying it brings down and demystifies it, but it just sort of makes people understand how the creative process starts and finishes, really.
Hello, I'm Neil Bunn, also known as Lord Bunn, and I am at the Bath Hotel. My installation is an artistic greengrocer's stall. When I looked into the history of the Bath Hotel, I found that it was originally a greengrocer's in the 1800s. It also sold beer on the side, but that's its origins. When I was thinking about a concept, I thought it'd be really nice to have a little bit of a nod to the history of the building, and also the fact the entire exhibition is only for one night. So by painting on fruit, it perishes. You either kind of had to come down and see it, or you don't get the chance to. Is art important for Sheffield? Yes, incredibly. I think that as industry went in Sheffield in the 80s, I think that spurred a lot of people on and created a really nice and welcoming hub of creativity in Sheffield, which is accepted and encouraged by almost every single part of Sheffield.
Yeah, everyone seems to really enjoy it. It's putting a smile on people's faces, and it's something that people haven't really seen before, so that's quite good.
We're off now to Bowray, and TADO have a big influence on Japan, so you're in for a little bit of Tokyo now. There are artists that I've come across throughout the last 5 years of being an artist myself, and they're the ones that have sort of stuck in my mind, and I thought, yeah, they've got something to say, they've got an interesting way of drawing and creating, and that was the reason behind it, really. Every one of them that I picked, whether I knew them or not, I knew their work was very distinctive, and I could rely on them to produce a good exhibition.
Alright, yeah,
well, can I help you out?
Oh, I was trying to get Shane's attention.
Does this open?
Do you want me to open it for
you? Are you going to get him?
Yeah. Hello? How are you, Shane? I was trying to get Shane! Shane!
How are you doing, mate? Oh wait, sir, can I have a
breath? Yes, of course. Is this on the... Have you got the stamp on your hand?
Yeah, no ice, please. No ice.
No ice.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, no worries, sir.
You can put it in this glass if you want. Hold on.
Do you want to keep the same glass?
Spritz,
oh, good. You've done your piece for the embroidery.
Are you filming?
Ready.
Come on.
The name's Shane Meadows. I'm on the Pub Scrawl. I'm only in this pub because they've got a This Is England themed. Well, it's not just This Is England. There's lots of films. Excuse that. Wolf have got a pub dedicated to them tonight.
Well, I'm going to be absolutely honest. Can I be honest?
Yeah, of course.
I didn't actually know what I was doing. I was just told to turn up, and I thought it was going to be a free piss up. But it's a pub crawl.
So anyone that takes art to normal places, I'm a big fan of. And I've been serving behind the bar, which I've enjoyed greatly, and I've decided now that when I retire, that's what I want to do. I want to get a place with Mark Kirby in Cornwall when our wives have had enough of us. So, yeah, loving it. Absolutely magic. And I'm hoping to go and see some of the other venues. I've heard one that's got a very, very large willy in it, and I want to see that one.
And I'm having a fantastic night. I've met some really nice people, like this lady here, that one over there, and all of them. And it's been really, really good. And you?
Okay.
Your name's?
Elena.
Who's
in tour 3? Yeah, fuck off! Seriously, fuck off! None of your lot in here now! Fucking hate them. Tour 3? Magic number? Fuck off. Hello!
Was a lot more mellow, a lot more organic than what we'd seen at the Washington, which was the This Is England guys. You guys are enjoying it? And we're off to the Frog and Parrot next. And again, the tour is really kind of building pace at the moment.
Let's go!
And again.
Can you tell we're
once
outside
more,
the forum?
Let's go!
People are really enjoying it. I think one of the key things we've seen, especially moving from the Bowery to the Washington to the Forum, is the dynamics and the difference in the art that's been displayed tonight. It's been an interesting evening.
I saw a very Clifton this morning.
What was he doing then?
He just had his scarf and he said hello.
I don't know if we ran it, Bernie Clifton.
The University Arms started up there for Ian Anderson, the Sanders Republic. It's like he inspired me really, so I wanted to see what was going on there.
Well, we're going in here now.
We're right, see you later, potatoes.
Just saying, if anybody wants to go in and have a look round,
We've seen
feel
it.
Feel free, do your stuff. If anybody wants chips, chip some.
Oh, that's it, I don't need chips.
Here we go. Have another chip.
It's dead good, it's dead good.
Yeah, shall we? Are we, is everybody out, or should we give a quick shout inside? Right, I'll stick my head front door and turn him out.
What he's done is kind of it exhibits like the whole collaborative attitude that Pete like creates have in Sheffield. Basically, like it's kind of like that whole Sheffield thing where you kind of go, I'm doing something. Do you want to get involved? Like, yeah, let's do it. Pete said you can do anything you want, but he was encouraging us to challenge ourselves. So I kind of thought instead of doing like, my usual drawing style and kind of painting, maybe I want to do something that was more related to what me and Nick always talk about. We saw it as model making, basically. We kind of, like, as we were sat in the studio, kind of spending late nights drinking coffee, food and stuff, whilst we were doing it with music on. It was kind of like when you were a kid and used to make models, and then we kind of realised at the same time, we used to hate making models. And somehow we found ourselves doing the same, like doing something that we really hated, but we wanted the end product. Well, basically, it's a temple of kind of like my characters and creations in a way. Like the two bears and the stag, they're kind of characters I've already written into like my own story. Yeah, I'm gonna draw this bear from scratch out of triangles and squares and things. And he just did it in a couple of days.
Are you in a tour?
Yeah, I'm
tour. Oh, sorry, I'm leaving the tour. Where are you heading?
Bungalows and bears. I've got the umbrella. I've got the high vis jacket.
It must be a tour.
I've got the hat. I've not got Ginger Dave yet.
Right, come on then. Bungalows and Bears is next.
We've worked with Pete for a number of years, done his books for him and stuff like that. So, and we've worked with Mick for the last 10 or so years. So it was just obviously a good chance to collaborate. No, no. Brothers Grimm.
Brothers Grimm.
Yeah. So I mean, it was a straightforward response to the Bungalows and Bears, the bears thing basically. So something to do with a bit. Came out of fairy tales and so on, and then we took it from there. Yeah, it's I mean, I think for something like this, it just you just see how everybody's kind of like how much effort everybody's put into something. Because it's not, yeah, it's not this. It's not like there's a lot of money involved. It's just like people do it because they want to do it and they want to, you know, they want to have a bit of energy on the streets, really. So it's yeah, definitely so.
Yeah, we planned it, but we didn't know how to make.
We wanted
it
some. We wanted some less Englishness going on. So when people are very reticent to enjoy art,
Mick said to me, "I want to knock them down." So that's what
so
we did.
Yeah. So, but everybody was kind of picking on the edges and got like, go and enjoy it. And like, because the boxes were modular, so you can play with them.
You can move around.
So, and they moved around. People were taking them away with them, so people were actually walking around the boxes.
No, it's actually
fine. It's only cardboard.
Yeah.
It's only cardboard, but I love it.
If there's stuff to be had,
I've got get 20 stuff.
This has been very much fun. Very, me like it very much. Knocking boxes over and stacking them back up again. Oh yeah, I never had proper building blocks in our little boy.
Right, okay, we've been on this pub scrawl thing. It's been amazing. Every bar we've been in, you know, there's been a little bit of this and a little bit of that. I'm not sure what the hell it is.
Brilliant. I've been to 7 so far out of 10, so about to pop into Dada Bar to see what's happening there, then only 2 more to go. Yes, yeah, it's been great. It's nice to see the city so vibrant and so much good creative stuff out there.
All I'm going to tell you is, we weren't just on Pub Scrawl. Tour Group 3 was Pub Scrawl.
I really wanted to do something different than I usually do, and animation's been interesting me for a while. I've never really had the chance to do something. And so I went to sort of roots of animation and the zoetrope and wanted to make things with those. I've loved animated GIFs for ages. It's a really simple way of making characters move with separate frames. So I've made some zoetropes using lamps, motorized lamps, to spin them and then having the animation inside. What I was going to do inside the animation has changed quite a lot over the last like month or so. I've ended up at a point I was quite happy with now. I didn't just want to do decoration, and this being the Dada bar and Dadaism being about anti-bourgeois, anti-establishment and sort of anti-art in a way, I like the idea of this sort of phallus that you might find on a toilet wall or a bus stop as sort of found art, and using that and creating a character out of that. So I've created sort of Dick Neakin as a character to animate in the zoetropes to represent that sort of, it's not a two fingers to art, it's just a bit of fun for the end of the night, for the tour, really, I think. But there's so many creative people in Sheffield, lots of illustrators and designers, so this is a real chance for those sort of people to really blossom and show what they're doing. But the sort of ethos of Pub Scrawl is quite unique because it's on one night, and it also puts a lot of pressure on each artist because they know everyone else, they know the other artists on Sheffield scene are all doing something on the same night, so there's a lot of pressure to really sort of do something good and not be shown up by sort of mediocrity.
We loved it, look. Since we're at pub number 10, we've done them all.
Pub number 10.
It's a bit worse for wear.
But the man at Harley did it all with a pen. All with like a whiteboard pen. It was amazing.
I found that if you went to a bar and paid some money, get a drink. Now that was art itself.
That is fantastic.
Nobody knew what it was going to be like, but it's absolutely fantastic. Everybody's having a great time, seeing some amazing art.
The last time we came in here, the boozer was empty. Tonight, it's doing the business, it's magic.
We thought it was fantastic.
Exactly, magic, man.
Do you know what it reminded us of? That guy from New York City, what's he called? What's that name of that guy?
It makes me happy. Things that make you happy, go on, you can't, you know.
It's beautiful,
you can't go wrong. Not at all. See you later.